Hello students, myself Dr. Sheetal Kulkarni and I am going to teach you Imaging Techniques Ultrasound Imaging. Points to be covered: Diagnostic Ultrasound, Physics of Ultrasonic Waves, Medical Ultrasound, Basic Pulse Echo Apparatus and A-Scan. Diagnostic Ultrasound. Ultrasound has become increasingly important in medicine and has taken its place along with the X-ray and nuclear medicine as a diagnostic tool. Its main attraction as an imaging modality lies in its non-invasive character and ability to distinguish interface between soft tissues. X-rays only respond to atomic weight differences and often require the injection of more dense contrast medium for visualization of non-bony tissues. Nuclear medicine techniques measure the selective uptake of radioactive isotopes in specific organs to produce information concerning organ function. Radioactive isotopes and X-rays clearly invasive. Ultrasound is only non-invasive, externally applied and non-traumatic, but also apparently safe at the acoustical intensities and duty cycles presently used in diagnostic equipment. Diagnostic ultrasound is applied for obtaining image of almost all the entire range of internal organs in the abdomen. This include kidney, liver, spleen, pancreas, bladder, major blood vessels, and of course the fetus during pregnancy. It has only been carefully employed to present pictures of the thyroid gland, the eyes, the breast, and the variety of other superficial structures. Diagnostic ultrasound is used in measurement of echocardium, abdominal ultrasound, including bladder, kidney, and renal ultrasounds, breast ultrasound, pregnancy ultrasound, scrotal ultrasound, thyroid ultrasound, and transvaginal ultrasound. The diagnostic ultrasound is applied for obtaining images of almost all the entire range. Physics of ultrasonic waves. Ultrasonic waves are sound waves associated with the frequencies above the audible range and generally extend upward from 20 kHz. These waves exhibit the same physical properties audible sound waves, but they are particularly preferred in the situation favored by one or more the following reasons. By using high frequency ultrasonic waves which are associated with shorter wavelengths, it is possible to investigate the properties of very small structure. It is particularly true in the detection of defects where the wavelengths utilized should be of the same order as the dimensions of the defect. Ultrasonic waves can be easily focused, they are directional, and beams can be obtained with very little spreading. Information obtained by ultrasound, particularly in dynamic studies, cannot be acquired by any other more convenient techniques. Characteristic impedance or the specific acoustic impedance of a medium is defined as the product of the density of the medium and the velocity of a sound in that medium. Z is equal to rho into V, where Z is the specific acoustic impedance, rho is the density of the medium, V is the velocity of sound in the medium. The characteristic impedance determines the degree of reflection and the refraction at the interface between the two media. The percent of the incident wave energy which is reflected, it is given by Z1 minus Z2 upon Z1 plus Z2 bracket square into 100%, where Z1 is the acoustic impedance of medium 1 and Z2 is the acoustic impedance of medium 2. Wavelength and frequency. Ultrasonics follow the general wavelength and the frequency relationship given V is equal to N into lambda, where V is the propagation velocity of sound, N is the frequency or number of cycles which pass any given point in unit time, lambda is the wavelength, that is distance between any two corresponding points on consecutive cycles. Ultrasonic frequencies employed for medical application range from 1 to 15 megahertz. This range also corresponds to radio frequency. There is an important basic difference between the radio frequency and the ultrasonic energy. Ultrasonic waves are transmitted as a mechanical vibrations, where RF energy will be in the form of electromagnetic radiations. No medium is necessary for propagation of energy, therefore pass even through the vacuum एंड अल्ट्रासोनिक वेव्स विल बी ऑन द अदर हैंड पास ओनली थ्रू मीडियम. द वेलोसिटी ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन, अल्ट्रासोनिक एनर्जी इज ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू द मीडियम एज अ वेव मोशन एंड देयरफॉर नो नेट मोमेंट ऑफ द मीडियम इज एक्सपेक्टेड. The velocity of propagation of wave motion is determined by the density of the medium and it is traveling through the stiffness of the medium. At a given temperature and pressure, the density and the stiffness of a biological substance are relatively constant and therefore the sound velocity in them is also constant. The speed of ultrasound in meter per second in various biological materials, it is shown on the slide. The knowledge of velocity of sound in a particular medium is important in calculating the depth to which the sound wave has penetrated before being reflected. If the time taken by the ultrasonic wave to move from the source through the medium, reflect from an interface and return to the source measure, the depth of penetration is calculated as velocity of sound in the medium into time divided by 2. The velocity of ultrasound in all the body tissues is almost constant and the depth of penetration can be read directly from the position of the echo pulse on the calibrated time axis of the oscilloscope trace. The velocity and characteristic impedance and absorption coefficient is shown on the slide. The reduction of amplitude of ultrasonic beam while passing through a medium can be due to this absorption by the medium and its deviation from the parallel beam of reflection and refraction, scattering and diffraction. The relative intensity and the attenuation of an ultrasonic beam is expressed in decibels and the absorption coefficient alpha is normally quoted in dB per centimeter. In soft tissues, alpha depends strongly on the frequency and therefore for a given amount of energy loss, the lower frequency ultrasonic signal will be traveled more than the higher frequency signal. Medical ultrasound. The use of ultrasound in the medical field can be divided into two major areas, the theranostic and diagnostic. The major difference between the two applications is the ultrasonic power level at which the equipment operates. The therapeutic application and the systems operate at ultrasonic power levels of up to several watts per square centimeter, while the diagnostic equipment operates at the power level below 100 milliwatt per centimeter. Therapeutic equipment is designed to agitate the tissue to the level where the thermal heating occurs in the tissue. For diagnostic purposes, on the other hand, as long as sufficient amount of signal has returned for electronic purposes, processing, no additional energy is necessary. Considerably lower ultrasonic power levels are employed for diagnostic application. Since the absorption of ultrasound in tissue is proportional to the operating frequency, is related to the desired resolution. That is ability to detect a certain size target. The choice of ultrasonic power level used is often detected by the application. Diagnostic ultrasound are used either as a continuous waves or in the pulsed wave mode. Application making use of continuous waves depend for their action on Doppler's effect. Basic diagram of pulse ecosystem is shown on the slide. Pulse eco technique of using ultrasound for diagnostic purposes in medical field attempted by making use of flaw detectors normally employed in industry for non-destructive testing of metallic structure. The transmitter generates a train of short duration pulses at a repetitive frequency determined by the PRF generator. These are converted into corresponding pulses of ultrasonic waves by a piezoelectric crystal acting as a transmitting transducer. The echoes from the target or discontinuity are picked up by the same transducer and amplified suitably or display on a cathode ray tube. The X plates of the CRT are driven by the time base, which starts at the instant when the transmitter radiates a pulse. The position of the echo along the trace is proportional to the time taken for a pulse to travel from the transmitter to the discontinuity and the back again. The probe. The transducer consists of a piezoelectric crystal which generates and detects ultrasonic pulses. The piezoelectric material generally used are barium titanate and lead zirconate titanate. The crystal is cut in such a way that it is mechanically resonant of an increased efficiency or conversion or electrical energy to acoustic energy. It is usually 1/2 wavelength thick for the particular frequency used. The probes are designed to achieve the highest sensitivity and penetration, optimum focal characteristics and best possible resolution. This requires that the acoustic energy be transmitted efficiently into the patient, and it is thus desirable to reduce the amount of reflected acoustic energy at the transducer body interface. Pulse repetition frequency generator. This unit produces a train of pulses which controls the sequence of events in the rest of the equipment. The PRF is usually kept between 500 Hz to 3 kHz. Transmitter. The transmitting crystal is driven by a pulse from a PRF generator and is made to trigger an SCR circuit, which discharges a capacitor through the piezoelectric crystal in the probe to generate an ultrasonic signal. Receiver. The function of the receiver is to obtain the signal from the transducer and to extract from it the best possible representation of an echo pattern to avoid significant worsening of the axial resolution. The receiver bandwidth is about twice the effective transducer bandwidth. Transmitter-receiver matching. Ultrasonic pulse ecosystems generally use the same transducer crystal for both transmitting the ultrasonic energy and receiving the reflected echo. Wideband amplifier. The echo signals received at the receiving transducer are in the form of modulated carrier frequency and may be as small as few microvolts. Swept gain control. Stronger echoes are received from the more proximal zones under examination than from the deeper structure. The receiving amplifier can only accept the limited range of input signals without overloading and distortion. Detector. After logarithmic amplification, the echo signals are rectified in the detector circuit. The detector employed could be of the conventional diode capacitor type with an inductive filter. Video amplifier. The signal requires further amplification after the demodulation in the detector circuit before it can be given to the viplets of the CRT. The output of the detector circuits is typically around 1 volt. But for display on the CRT, the signal must be amplified to about 100 to 150 volt. Time delay unit. The time delay unit is sometimes required for special applications. Normally, the time base will begin to move the spot across the CRT phase at the same moment as the SCR is fired. Time base. The time base speed is adjusted so that echoes from the deepest structure of interest will appear on the screen before the beam has completely traversed, Breaking the speed of the ultrasound in soft tissues to be about 1500 m per second. A time of 13.3 microseconds must be allowed. Time marker. The time marker produces pulses that are known time apart and therefore corresponds to known distance apart in human tissues. These marker pulses are given to the video amplifier and then to the viplets of display along with the echoes. The after amplification in the video amplifier, the signal is given to the viplets of the CRT. CRT is not only a fast-acting device but also gives a clear presentation of the received echo signals. A scan. The echo signals are applied to the y-deflecting plates of the CRT so that they are displayed as a vertical blips as the beam is swept across the CRT. The height of the vertical blip corresponds to the strength of the echo, and its position from left to right across the CRT phase correspond to the depth of its point of origin from the transducer. For A-scan application, the CRT is usually of the electrostatic deflection type. The better used CRT with post-deflection acceleration of the electron beam so that a very bright trace is obtained with the lower deflecting voltage on the plates. Application of A-scan, they are mostly used for echoencephalogram. In the normal brain, the midline surfaces are parallel to the flat areas of the bone near the ear. When there is a head injury, the brain tilted to one side or other due to bleeding, but it still returns to normal shape. In such case, the echoes can be easily obtained, but they are placed at different distances from the probe. When the probe is placed first on one side and then on the other side of the skull, even when the tumor grows in the brain, the autonomy of the brain Anatomy of the brain is gently altered and there is a usually considerable tilting and displacement of the brain ventricles. Ultrasonic midline echo immediately establishes the abnormality of the brain due to the shift to one side from the center. The instrument for diagnosis and detection of the midline of the brain is called echoencephaloscope. It usually incorporates a measuring range of 0 to 18 cm of the tissue depth. The normally used frequency range is 1 to 3 MHz. Second application is echo-ophthalmoscope. A mode ultrasonic technique has been found to be useful in ophthalmology for the diagnosis of retinal detachments, intraocular tumors, vitreous opacities, orbital tumors, and lens dislocation. It helps in the measurement of axial length in patients with progressive myopia, localization of intraocular foreign bodies, and extraction of non-magnetic foreign bodies. Echo-ophthalmoscopy employs a 7.5 to 15 MHz pencil-type transducer.